At 6:02 a.m. local time on February 8, 2024, a new volcanic eruption began at Iceland's Reykjanes volcano. As the fissure opened up 4,500 meters northeast of the town of Grindavik, expanding gases propelled the erupting magma upwards, generating a series of 150-meter or 492-foot-high lava fountains. The fissure then unzipped both to the northeast and south, and within 30 minutes of the eruption onset had expanded to three segments with a combined length of 2,400 meters. As the entire length of the fissure erupted lava at what I estimate to be approximately 190 cubic meters per second, we witnessed something that had not occurred at the other five volcanic eruptions on the same peninsula since 2020. What I am referring to are ash emissions, indicating that the ongoing eruption, despite being primarily effusive, has a weak explosive component to it. This ash has been ejected in an approximately 200-meter-high plume, but alongside fine particles also carried with it lightweight tephra up to 8 centimeters in diameter. Due to the southwestern wind direction, these fragments subsequently fell on the town of Grindavik, falling up to 5 kilometers away from their source vent. While ash emissions are ongoing at a low level, there does not appear to be any significant danger of disruptions to nearby airports, as the ash is keeping to a low level and blowing away from the direction most aircraft would be. While this ash has not truly accumulated to a measurable amount, you might be wondering how much material has been emitted and if this amount would be sufficient to categorize the ongoing eruption as not a 0, but a 1 on the Volcanic Explosivity Index. To this I say the eruption is thankfully still a 0, as up to 9,999 cubic meters of ash can be emitted before a designation of a 1 is made. Based on the fairly sparse reports of ash and tephra fall, I estimate that only between 200 and 1,000 cubic meters of tephra has been emitted. However, the mere presence of this tephra likely indicates a greater gas content in the eruption, creating a greater upward force than seen during the last two eruptions in December of 2023 and January of 2024. This gas caused some magma to expand and fragment to such an extent that it became fine particles. It is also equally possible that the increased snow on the ground created additional groundwater which the magma reacted with, causing fragmentation. Yet, while heavy ashfall and severe aircraft disruptions do not seem to be an issue, two things are major issues. Both of these relate to the still-expanding lava flows which have largely flowed in a western direction, as a lava from the December 2023 eruption acted as a porous but still impactful lava barrier of sorts. As of hour 9 of the eruption, lava has flowed 3,200 meters to the west, not only flowing onto and cutting off a major road, but also breaking and then covering the source of hot water to a little more than 20,000 people. The affected area, which currently has no hot water, includes but is not limited to the town of Keflavik and Iceland's main international airport. While the important Svartsengi geothermal power plant is still technically at risk, its recently constructed lava barrier has already paid dividends, blocking a portion of the advancing lava flow that otherwise would have hit crucial infrastructure. While lava is thankfully not heading towards Grindavik, it is still not safe to be within the town at this time, so please keep out of the current hazard zones and its vicinity while also staying off closed roads. This eruption, like the last two, is likely to produce no more than 12 million cubic meters of lava and will last no more than 72 hours in duration. Lava flow forward progress has already almost come to a complete halt, and soon we will witness the deactivation of two of the fissures, after which only a single dominant vent will remain on the active fissure. Thus, by February 11th of 2024, this latest eruption of the Reykjanes volcano should be over. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.